When you first look at these basketball players, they're like any other high school students, anxious before a big game. They're no different, except for the fact that they're deaf. The team is from the California School for the Deaf at Riverside. The coach, Seymour Bernstein. A few weeks ago, they made it to the finals in the first annual basketball tournament for the deaf at Laney College in Oakland. During their regular season, they played against other high schools whose players were not deaf. But in this tournament, their intense desire to win was apparent. Team captain John Roberts is a senior at the California School for the Deaf. He's been deaf since the age of 3. John, as well as his teammates, came expecting to win. I talked to John through the assistant coach, Ken Marai. Does he personally, what does he feel when he's out on the court playing basketball?
I feel nervous because I always want to win the game.
How do you feel? Do you feel out there any different than any other basketball player?
Just accept my deafness and play basketball.
Are there any advantages to being deaf and playing basketball? Do they have a better sense?
Yes.
Can you tell me what they are?
Eyes. My eyes.
How does...
And I can feel the vibrations or senses of the floor, the vibrations of the floor.
Tell him that for us who are unaware of the deaf people, we tend to think that this basketball game may be different.
We'll prove it to them by playing good basketball.
Play they did. And Riles, the state superintendent of schools here in California. Dr. Riles, how are you enjoying the game so far?
I'm having a great time. It's a wonderful game. The competition is great. The enthusiasm is high. It's a wonderful thing.
The team feels they are no different than any other basketball team. And I guess we on the other side have to be knowledgeable of that and educated to that. Do you find that to be true?
Yes. Some people look on people with certain handicaps as a minority or odd or strange, and they aren't. As a matter of fact, to be able to cope with a handicap like deafness shows a little superiority, if you ask me.
As in any basketball game, there are winners and losers. And even the consolation of one of the Riverside cheerleaders did little to ease John Roberts' pain at having lost the big one.